गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम अगेन इन द कोर्स कॉन्क्रीट टेक्नोलॉजी। वी सॉ इन लास्ट लेक्चर ट्रांसपोर्टिंग डिपोजिशन ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट इन डिटेल, इन विच वी सॉ द ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट, देन इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट इन द ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑपरेशन, देन precautions to be taken for transporting concrete from place of mixing to the place of where concreting is to be done, then safety during transportation, then deposition of concrete, precautions of deposition of concrete we saw in last lecture in detail. Also we saw the compaction of concrete, in which we saw importance of concrete, importance of compaction in concreting, in which we also saw the hand compaction in detail. Today we are going to see the mechanical compaction, compaction by pressure and jolting, compaction by spinning. Let's see one by one. First of all, mechanical compaction. In case of mechanical compaction, concrete is compacted by vibrations, during which the vibrator communicates rapid vibrations to the particles, thus increasing the mobility of concrete. The particles occupy a more stable position under the force of gravity due to vibrations. The concrete mix fills all the spaces, thus forcing air to the surface and making concrete denser. The frequency and duration of vibration, its amplitude depend on the conditions of vibrations for compacting the concrete mix. The maximum frequency of vibrations depend on the size of the particles and on the mobility of concrete. The advantages of vibrating compactions are, it gives a better finish and better quality of concrete as obtained compared to hand compaction. The concrete produced is more dense and impermeable. Next advantage is, bond between steel and concrete is improved. Then speed of placing concrete is increased by the ready flow of vibrated concrete into difficult positions. Then creep and shrinkage are also reduced due to the possibility of higher aggregate cement ratio. The difficulty also arises in encountered in vibratory compaction. Difficulty is the finishing of horizontal surface. Then second difficulty is discharging very stiff concrete from mixers. The lack of sufficient vibrations at point not immediately in contact with the vibrating equipment, thus resulting in segregation of concrete. Then discharging stiff concrete from lorries and other means of transport. These are the difficulties encountered in vibratory compaction, in mechanical compaction. Next point is compaction by pressure and jolting. This is one of the effective method of compacting very dry concrete. This method is used for compacting hollow blocks, cavity blocks and solid concrete blocks. The stiff concrete is vibrated, pressed and also given jolts, and due to this the stiff concrete get compacted to dense form to give good strength. Next point is compaction by spinning. Spinning is one of the recent method of compaction of concrete and is used for the fabrication of concrete pipes. The plastic concrete fin spun in at a very high speed gets well compacted by centrifugal force. Compaction by spinning is the recent or new method. Then next point is types of vibrators used for vibrating or compacting concrete. The vibrators commonly used are classified as internal vibrator, skid vibrator, foam vibrator, table vibrator and platform vibrator. The use of all vibrators is depend upon the site conditions to be concrete. Let's see one by one. Internal vibrator. The internal vibrator is looks like as shown in figure. It's also known as needle vibrator. Internal vibrator is also known as needle or immersion or poker vibrator. It consists of a power unit and a long flexible tube at the end of which fitted a vibrating head. These vibrators have higher efficiency since all the energy is directly transmitted to the concrete. As they are portable, therefore they can be readily used in difficult positions. The vibrating element is immersed in the fresh concrete, which transmit vibrations through the vibrator body. It is very important to keep the vibrating head in the concrete while draining in order to keep the bearings cool and avoid breakdown. It should be inserted vertically or nearly so at points 45 cm to 75 cm apart and should be withdrawn slowly at the rate of 7.5 cm per second. This should not be used for pushing concrete laterally in the formwork because it will cause segregations. The frequency of vibrations is about 7000 cycles per minute. Such vibrators are used for compacting large sections of mass concrete in structures for concrete of beams, column and foundations. Then skid vibrator is also known as surface vibrator. These vibrators are used for compacting plain concrete or one-way reinforced concrete floors, road surfaces, the thickness of which does not exceed 20 cm. This vibrator is set up on the concrete surface after placing the concrete and vibrations are transmitted to the concrete through a working platform. This is a skid vibrator is a surface vibrator used for pavement or road surfaces. Then third vibrator type is foam vibrator. Foam vibrators are also known as external vibrator. It is fastened to the formwork by a clamping device and transmit vibration to the concrete. External vibrator is clamped at a distance up to 25 cm in depth from the formwork. The formwork should be sufficiently strong and rigid to resist the oscillations. The time of vibration is from 45 to 90 seconds. Foam vibrators are used in concreting of thin components of monolithic structures, heavily reinforced arches and tunnel lining, etc. They are also used in the production of different precast reinforced concrete components. Then table the vibrator. This method is mostly adopted in laboratories. This is the special case of Homer vibrator, where the vibrator is clamped to the table. This method is used in making small but precise prefabricated reinforced cement concrete members. In this method, any member kept on the table gets vibrated. Then platform vibrators. It is nothing but a table vibrator larger in size. Sometimes the platform vibrator is also coupled with jerking or shock giving arrangements so that a through compression is given to the concrete. Platform vibrators is used in the manufacture of large prefabricated concrete elements such as railway sleepers, prefabricated roofing elements, electric poles, etc. Next point is curing of concrete. The process of hardening the concrete mixes by keeping its surface moist for a certain period after compaction and finishing is called curing of concrete. Curing is one of the important factors for obtaining better strength. The concrete hardens because of the chemical reaction between water and cement, that is hydration reaction. The chemical action that accompanies the setting of concrete is dependent on the presence of water is retained water. Although there is sufficient water at time of mixing, it is necessary to ensure that the water is retained to enable the chemical action to continue till the concrete is fully hydrated. Properties of concrete such as strength, durability and wear resistance, water tightness and volume stability improves with the passage of time. 3 gallons of water are required approximately to hydrate 1 bag of cement. The water requirement for hydration reaction, that is consistency of cement, near about 35% to 38% is water required for hydration reaction of cement. Then the importance of curing of concrete is to improve its properties such as water tightness, wear resistance, strength, volume stability and durability of concrete. The objective of curing is to maintaining the process of hydration by preventing the loss of water by evaporation. Then also to reduce the shrinkage of concrete and to preserve the properties of concrete. Then methods of curing. Different methods of curing are used for maintaining the concrete in a moist condition over a time of several days till it hardens and attains full strength. The method of curing depends upon the nature of work and atmospheric conditions. Following methods are generally used for curing. One is sprinkling water. This is excellent method of curing. It is the continuous sprinkling of water. The quantity of water required by this method to cure concrete is much more than other methods. If water is sprinkled in intervals, then the concrete must not be allowed to dry between application of water. A constant supply of water helps in preventing the formation of cracks caused by alternate wetting and drying. Second method is ponding method. Bonding method is mainly adopted for surface sphere surfaces members such as pavement, floors, slabs, roofs and sidewalks, etc. It is mostly used method of curing for slabs where bonds are created by normal mortar for storing or retaining water in the pond. In this method, a small dam of earth or water retaining material is placed around the perimeter of the surface. The surface is freshly covered for 24 hours after placing and compacting concrete. The enclosed area is further divided into a number of rectangles and is kept flooded with water. Water is filled in the rectangles 2 or 3 times per day depending upon the climatic conditions. The next method is membrane curing. Membrane curing is used at the places where there is acute shortage of water. In membrane curing, a newly laid concrete surface is covered by using chemical or liquid membranes in order to prevent evaporation of moisture from concrete. This method has been found good in maintaining a satisfactory state of wetness in the body of concrete to promote continuous hydration when original water cement ratio use is not less than 0.5. Next method is covering concrete surfaces with gunny bags. In our area, mostly the gunny bags are used for curing purpose. The exposed surface of concrete is covered with old empty cement bags or hessians, which are kept moist by spraying water frequently. This method is widely used for structural concrete. This method can also be applied for horizontal and vertical members. The surface should not be allowed to dry even for small duration during the period of curing. Then shading concrete works. The object of shading is to avoid the evaporation of water from the surface of concrete after its place and compacted. This method is used to protect the newly laid concrete from wind, heat and direct sun rays. Then chemical curing. Chemical curing is accomplished by spraying the sodium silicate solution, about 500 grams sodium silicate mixed with water can cover 1 meter square of surface area and forms a hard and insoluble calcium silicate film. It actually acts as a case hardener and curing agent. The application of sodium silicate results in a thin varnish like film which also fill pores and surface voids, thus sealing the surface and preventing the evaporation of water. The next method of curing is steam curing. The hydration of cement accelerates with increase in temperature, which leads to faster development of strain. To steam curing, the concrete is subjected to higher temperature by maintaining the required wetness. For concrete mixes with water cement ratio ranging from 0.3 to 0.7, the increased rate of strain development can be achieved by resorting to steam curing. The precast members are passed through the steam chambers for steam curing. It is also used when early removal of formwork is required to put the structure in sense without delay. Then curing of concrete by infrared radiation. This is very normally not used method of curing. This is very rare method of curing. It is claimed that a much more rapid gain of strength can be obtained in this method than even with steam curing. The rapid initial rise of temperature does not result in a decrease in the ultimate strength, as it does not as it does in the case of steam curing. The system is described as particularly applicable to the manufacture of hollow concrete products, in which case the heaters are placed in the hollow spaces of the product. The normal operating temperature is 90 degrees Celsius. The curing of concrete by infrared radiation has been used in Russia. Then last method is electrical curing of concrete. This method is not used in India. It is more expensive. It is mostly used in very cold climatic regions. Passing alternating current of low voltage can cure concrete products and high amperage through electrodes in the form of plates covering the entire area of two opposite faces of concrete. The potential difference generally adopted is between 30 and 60 volts. Then effect of delayed curing. The concrete specimens placed in laboratory air for varying periods after casting before being moist cured have indicated that the strength at 7 to 28 days decreases progressively as the period of air curing is increased. An exposure for 3 days to air at a temperature of 23 degrees Celsius and having a relative humidity of approximately 60% before being moist cured at 23 degrees Celsius has been found to reduce the 7 days strength by 12% and the 28 days strength by about 10%. The specimens left in air at 23 degrees Celsius for the entire curing period have shown in reduction of 25% in the strength at 7 and 28 days as compared to with standard moist curing. Then duration of curing. As per IS 456/1964, the concrete should be cured for at least 7 days. The strength of concrete increased by 50% than that which is exposed to dry air for the entire period. All the properties of concrete are improved by curing. Therefore, it must be as long as practicable in all cases. Concrete must be kept at a temperature that is favorable for hydration. Strength of concrete with different rates of curing. As per IS 456, for one day curing, the strength in 16% strength will be gained by concrete. For 3 days, 40% strength. For 7 days, 67%. 28 days, 100%, 3 months, 122%, half year, 146%, and 1 year, 155%. This is all about the transportation, compaction, deposition, and curing of concrete, and precaution to be taken for all the operation at the time of concreting. Thank you.